This video was brought to you by GeneralPack.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Consider subscribing and supporting through patreon.com/GeneralPack. This is the mechanism for you to support us financially so we can continue making high-quality power system video tutorials. Our corporate sponsor for this topic is AllumiaX.com from Seattle, Washington. Contact them for industrial and commercial power system studies. Introduction to Per Unit Systems Part 1C, completing the per unit example. In the previous video, Part 1B, we discussed about the per unit formula and the base values and solved a very small part of an example. In this video, Part 1C, we will complete Part A and Part B of that same example. The example is taken from a book called Electric Machinery Fundamentals by Stephen Chapman, edition number 4. In this example, in region 1, we have a 480 volt generator at 0 degrees, and there's a step-up transformer, which leads us to region 2. In region 2, we have a transmission line that's 20 ohm resistance and 60 ohm reactance, and then there's a step-down transformer, which leads us to region 3. In region 3, we have a load that's 10 ohms at 30 degrees. We are told in this example that the base value for the system is chosen to be 480 volts at 10 kVA at the generator. In part A, we are asked to find the base voltage, current, and impedance, and apparent power at every point in the power system. B, convert the system to per unit equivalent circuits. C, find the power supply to the load in the system. D, find the power lost in the transmission line. We will not be solving part C and D since our objective is to focus on the per unit part of the problem. Now, part A, find out the base values of the different regions. We solved this in our previous video. For region 1, we calculated the base value for I base and Z base, and using the given values of V base and S base, the answers were simply I base is equal to 20.83 amps, and Z base was equal to 23.04 ohms. This is for region 1. Region 2. First, let's write down the base value that are given for region 2. We know that the rating of the generator, both as V base and S base, for region 1. Since there is a step-up transformer between region 1 and region 2, the V base for region 2 would be different, however the S base will remain the same. In fact, the S base will remain the same for region 1, region 2, and region 3. So the S base for region 2 is simply equal to 10 kVA, which again will remain the same for the entire system. Now let's find out about the base voltage by using the transformer turns ratio. We can simply find out the voltage on the secondary side of the transformer by using the following equation. The voltage on the primary side divided by the voltage on the secondary side is equal to the number of turns ratio on the primary side divided by the number of turns ratio on the secondary side. Since Vp is equal to V1 base, which is equal to 480 volts, we know that 480 volts divided by Vs is equal to 1 divided by 10. Rearranging and solving for Vs, well, Vs is equal to 4800 volts. We know that this is the base voltage for region 2, so V2 base is equal to 4800 volts. Now, we can easily calculate the other base values. So I2 base is equal to S2 base divided by V2 base, which is simply equal to 10 kVA divided by 4800 volts, which is equal to 2.083 amps. Z2 base is equal to V2 base divided by I2 base, which is equal to 4800 volts divided by 2.083 amps, which equals 2304 ohms. We can also calculate these values by using the transformer turns ratio formula. So now that we have calculated all four base values for region 2, let's move on to region 3. The base power is the same for the entire system, which equals S3 base is equal to 10 kVA. Again, since there's a step-down transformer linking region 2 and region 3, we can employ the calculation process we did for region 2. Voltage on the primary side divided by the voltage on the secondary side is equal to the number of primary turns divided by the number of secondary turns. Now, which is equal to 4800 volts divided by Vs equals 20 divided by 1. Rearranging this and solve for Vs equals 240 volts. So V3 base is equal to 240 volts. So we can easily calculate the other base values. I3 base is equal to S3 base divided by V3 base, which is equal to 10 kVA divided by 240 volts, which equals 41.67 amps. And Z3 base is equal to V3 base divided by I3 base, and that equals 240 volts divided by 41.67 amps. And that equals 5.76 ohms. So now we have calculated the voltage base, impedance base, power base, and the current base for region 1, region 2, and region 3. Now that we have completed part B of the problem of the base values for every region of the power system, let's move on to the next part. In part B, we are asked to convert into per unit equivalent system. Now, the per unit equivalent consists of the components of the individual regions. Region 1 is a generating region, so the equivalent would be the source. Region 2 is a transmission line, so the equivalent would be the per unit impedance of the transmission line. And region 3 consists of the load, so the equivalent circuit would be contain the per unit impedance of the load. And we know that the generic formula to find out the per unit value is simply equals per unit value is equal to the actual value divided by the base value. And again, we calculated the base value for all of three regions. For region 1, we calculated the VPU in part 1B, which was given as 1 per unit. For region 2, we will calculate the per unit impedance of the transmission line, which is equal to Z2 per unit, which is equal to Z2 actual divided by Z2 base. Well, Z2 actual is equal to 20 plus J60 ohms, and the Z2 base is equal to 2304 ohms. That is equal to 0.0087 plus J.0260 per unit. And keep in mind that this is a per unit value. Region 3, we will calculate the per unit impedance of the load connected to the power system. So Z3 per unit is equal to Z3 actual divided by Z3 base. Well, Z3 actual is equal to 10 ohms at 30 degrees. And Z3 base is equal to 5.76 ohms. That gives us 1.73 at the angle of 30 degrees per unit. Since now we have calculated the per unit values, we will draw the equivalent circuit. And the equivalent circuit will be very, very simple. It has a voltage source of 1 per unit, and then it has a resistive component and a reactive component at 0.0087 per unit and J.0260 per unit. And then it has a load at 1.736 at 30 degrees per unit. As you can see, the per unit equivalent circuit is more simple because we have eliminated the different voltage levels completely and thereby eliminated the region 1, region 2, and region 3 boundaries. This simplification is one of the biggest reasons why we use per unit systems in power systems. In the next video, we will look at per unit formulas for single phase and three phase systems. We hope you have a continued interest in this topic and series as a student or professional, and we also hope you find this content useful and enlightening. Please consider subscribing to GeneralPack.com or becoming our Patreon at patreon.com/GeneralPack. GeneralPack.com, we make high quality power system video tutorials on complex topics that are free and open to everyone. Thank you.